Recently, members of the Environment and Natural Resources Committee, while visiting Isimba Hydro Power Plant, questioned why Uganda exports power to Kenya while majority of locals cannot access electricity.
Ugandanese, and you are giving priority to Kenyanese, Tanzanianese, Rwandese, when, for example, my village is here in Mukono South, here, they don't have power, but you have somebody as far as Kenya enjoying power, somebody as far as DRC enjoying power. And at the end of the day, I think ERA should clarify on that.
Uganda earned $26.84 million, an equivalent of $95.3 billion by June 2021, from electricity exports to Kenya. This was an increase from $24.5 million, an equivalent of 87 billion shillings, earned by June 2020. In response, the Permanent Secretary at the Ministry of Energy and Mineral Development attributed the low access in Uganda to an inadequate transmission and distribution network.
Well, what we are seeing today, the power trade with Kenya is largely power that we are unable today to get to the end user due to the insufficient or lack of a sufficient distribution and transmission infrastructure.
This is a measure to mitigate stagnation of power as we await for adequate funding of the grid extensions and transmission lines to the various parts of the country, in addition to funding for the last mile connecting the household.
Inadequate electricity infrastructure is one of the thorny issues Uganda has continued to grapple with as agitations for electricity connections increase day by day with its growing generation capacity. Since 2018, the government has been considering the idea of opening the transmission segment to the private sector as one way of attracting finance to the sector.
I believe that this study will put in place a framework that will be transparent enough to attract cost-effective investments in the transmission network that will deliver value for money to the Ugandans. And we are looking at what we call tariff neutral projects. What are tariff neutral projects? These are projects, if invested in, immediately they are commissioned, there is demand in waiting, the consumption quickly grows, that the line pays for itself.
The agency has already indicated that they have received expression of interest from four companies but have been told to wait until the completion of the framework by March next year. Once complete, the framework is expected to open the transmission segment to private sector participation. This is expected to drive investments into the area that is currently constrained. Story by Ben Onojambo for the news.